Okay, Rael, why did you turn your lights off?
You kind of remind me of Shaggy from Scooby-Doo.
Some people do know me as Shaggy, but it wasn't Scooby-Doo.
Oh! God, Bang! Thank you. Shaz, why is your light so? You're feeling a bit frisky tonight.
Yeah. I'm just loving your enthusiasm for everything. It's like I could picture you waking up in the morning like, yes, today! I need that. I need
morning world! Andy's here! Scooby-Dooby-Doo! What about you?
Oh my god, I'm from London. Where about you from?
From North London, Barnet, you know?
Ah.
Too far. We're going to have a bit of a chat. Lucy, why's your light on?
Hi, Nikki.
Hi, how's it going?
Oh, she put a Y on the end.
I like
it. Yeah, do you want to know why? Because he's my ex-boyfriend.
It's all a dream. Olivia, one of the two, that's okay. What the... Oh, you never said anything! What was I going to do? You could have gone, hey, Paddy, that's my ex-girlfriend! I said a word!
Natasha, why did you turn off?
Hi, Scott. I'm sorry, but I do like on men a bit...
Craig! Scott's gone! This is his sister! There's his mum and dad!
No, I do that. Like, I do get names confused. I do it all the time. It's just that I do like on men a little bit of body hair.
I just wanted it to run smoothly in Fernando's, that was all.
Oh! Harriet, why did you turn off?
When you came down, you took a step forward and you've got bright blue socks on.
The socks do come off, you know.
He's hanging about. I was hoping I could hang out with you and Fernando.
Laurie, you kept your lights on.
I tell you what, wardrobe will kill me for this, but...
Oh! So why did you keep your lights on?
Well, you look a bit like a pirate and I look a bit like Jack Sparrow.
I don't think you want to go on a date with Jack Sparrow, if I'm being honest.
You could definitely be my treasure.
Let me go out and have a chat to the girls. Shanine! A Northern Irish girl, you've turned your lights off. What's going on?
Are you on Tinder, Leslie? I know you're on Tinder.
Hashtag ox. Oh dear.
He didn't write back.
Oh, he didn't write back.
I'm a little bit of a thrill seeker myself. I've done shark diving, bungee jumping as
shark
well.
Shark diving?
Yeah.
Wow.
It was in Liverpool, I'm not going to lie.
Shark diving? What, in the canal? All right, OK. Fair enough. Alicia, why's your light on?
Hiya, well, I'm from Sunderland and I think we are match made in heaven. I am not turning this light off, OK?
That's you. That is you told. Billy May, why is your light on?
I used to really fancy Milo from the Tweenies.
Oh, God, look what you've done. Look what you've done. What the hell is that?
There's a seal got loose in the building. There's a seal.
Oh, my. Quick, come over here. Come over here. Come over here. Turn 30 lights on,
cannot
one
complain.
Seal, it's unbelievable. Welcome to the show, Anna, how are you? Now, I'm told you've got an absolutely fantastic party trick.
Yes, I have.
Wow. What is it?
I can peel a cucumber with my teeth.
I think we've got to see it, haven't we?
Oh, God.
Yeah. We've got to see it. We've got a cucumber, hang on.
I've got a white dress on, so you'll have to.
Do you want me to put this bib on you?
Yeah.
Here we go.
Thanks,
here we go. Okay.
Right, is everyone ready?
Oh, God, yeah. off you go.
Why did you turn off?
Everyone's saying that his jumper reminded them of Dennis the Menace, but it reminds me of Freddy Krueger. Oh. I had a Freddy Krueger when I was younger. I don't think I could do it,
Meg. I need to search deeper in my wardrobe because Dennis the Menace and Freddy Krueger is a weird mix.
That is a very heady mixture. Georgia, you kept your light on.
I'm from Cornwall, and I'm used to like seeing people much more chilled, so it's quite nice to see, like, almost a familiar face.
Yeah, sure. I mean, maybe we can go surfing down there sometime.
I don't surf, but yeah.
All right. Well, that was easy. Why is your life
gone? Well, I love the whole clean cut look, but there's... You look a little rough and ragged, and I like it.
Oh. Maddie, to be honest with you, obviously, I look on the pristine on the outside, but I'm dirty on the inside.
Oh, beautiful.
I'm a married man, Adam. You've got to warn me of these things. Down here. Emily, why's your light on?
I like how your muscles look like they're really squashed into your t-shirt.
And it was took a few to get this on, I'll tell you that.
Oh, I'll help next time.
Do you like how he's packed into that shirt?
Yeah, he's packed in all right.
Pop out at any time.
Christy, why did you turn off?
I look a man with a bit more muscle. I feel like my guns might be a bit bigger than yours.
I'm big in the right places, Christy.
Big Ben. Right, okay. Why's your life on?
I love that you're a dentist. Like, I had my braces up when I was like 16, but I still wear my retainers now because literally I hate bad teeth.
Oh, well, I'm sure I could introduce you to my drill.
Came down the lift and then you were walking around there like you look like a cowboy in a real light Toy Story.
I could be your Woody.
Lee, you were waving it.
I don't care what you're wearing. I love a ginger.
Ginger males are born with a love flame, so, baby, let me light your fire.
Oh, the love flame! Why do you like shining?
His shirt reminds me of a picnic blanket, and I could just eat him up, buddy.
Very saucy. Lulu, why's your light still on?
His voice is like... very soothing. Never mind the picnic, it's like you're going to be a snake coming out of the basket.
Please, Peter, don't say anything about snakes coming out. No, no, snakes. Great first round, pal. Girls
thank
are warm.
You. Thank you very much, girls.
Good entrance. After round one, Big Pete has high hopes for a date, but will the girls like Peter's patter when he tells us more about him in the next? Ladies, if you like him tall, don't touch it at all.
I've lived and travelled all around the world, so I'm looking for a girl with a good sense of adventure. I've been plus-size modelling for 3 years now. Girls, I'm of the opinion bigger is always better. As well as modelling, I'm also an actor. I've been involved in 14 movies, alongside people such as Brad Pitt, Liam Neeson. Liam Neeson even encouraged me to write my book about my life growing up in a safari in South Africa. Being a man of the wild, I've lived a life of adventure, and I have a huge love for animals.
Are you hungry?
I've survived rhino attacks, close encounters with a warthog. That officially scared the crap out of me. And being bitten by snakes twice. And yes, I actually do know how to talk to animals. Kind of like a modern Dr. Doolittle.
We gonna get a selfie together? No?
So which wild girls fancies a date with this wild guy?
Girls turned the lights off, but 15 girls kept them on. Let me go out and have a chat to the girls. Gabriella!
I get so much attention for being Australian and all the spider and snake stories I have. You beat me.
Tell us about that.
When I was 7 years old, I got bitten twice, 3 months apart, all on the exact same foot. First one was dangerous. The second one was a grass snake, but it hung on to me and didn't kind of jump off for about 40, 50 metres. So.
I'm the same with the old snake back. 12 pints, I'm on the floor, so... Speaking of animals, get it out quick. Hey, where was Peter? Hey! Look at
that!
Hey!
Hang on
a minute. What the hell's that down there?
See, I know what it is.
Why do you keep your eyes on?
Well, I've always wanted to meet a giraffe.
I mean, there's no giraffes in Fernando's, but we'll see what I can do for you. Callie, why is your light shining?
Do you know what it was? I love travelling. I've literally travelled since I was really young. And also, my house is literally like a wildlife park.
Are you looking for an animal lover?
I think any of you girls who've got a passion for wildlife, particularly with everything that happens out there in the world today, it's always going to be great.
Oh, Peter, we love you, Peter. We love you.